SETI, S-E-T-I, stands for the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. It's a word that describes a wide variety of different kinds of searches which are being made all over the world for evidence of the existence of other civilizations in space. Almost all of the searches that are being done with telescopes. Our goal is to detect in those searches radio and radar transmissions from other civilizations. The first result that comes from this is simply the knowledge that other civilizations exist in space. That, of course, would be an enormous milestone in history of human civilization. Why do we search? It is because everything we know about our universe, about our planetary system, and about the origin and evolution of life on Earth seems to say that all of these things were the result of completely normal processes that occur in our galaxy. No special phenomena, no freak events were required for our civilization to exist as it does. Given the enormous number of stars in the galaxy, which are like the sun, it follows that there should be many, many civilizations in our galaxy and in other galaxies. If they practice technology as we do, they are detected. This is a recent development. Until a few decades ago, our instruments were not sensitive enough to detect reasonable manifestations of intelligent life. That is, they could not detect the same sorts of signals and power levels that we ourselves radiate. However, we have crossed an important threshold in that we have developed instruments which can detect signals no stronger than we radiate across the vast distances which separate the stars. In fact, our present radio telescopes, if used properly, can detect Earth-like signals all the way from the far side of the galaxy. Therefore, it is reasonable to search. There would be an enormous intellectual payoff in the detection of other civilizations. Their mere existence is a very important fact which will influence our thinking, our philosophy, our outlook on life. We will learn almost certainly facts of science, evolution, biology, and other places which we could not learn by any other means. We would see what prospects there are for the future of civilizations, what becomes of them, how do they manage their resources, what ways of life do they adopt. All of these things are interesting in their own right. At the same time, they provide very useful information in developing their own resources or planning their own activities.
I'll get back to a couple of your statements a bit later on. You obviously have touched on the subject, but I'd like to be a bit more specific. According to your formula, ours is not the only civilization. Why do we start with the assumption, scientifically speaking, that there must be other civilizations?
Our theoretical understanding of the formation of stars and our observations suggest that stars are formed. Not alone, but must be accompanied by another object or objects. And indeed, about half the stars in the sky are double stars. We believe, from what we have seen and our theories again, that the remainder of the stars, or indeed even some of the double stars, are accompanied by planetary systems. The theory of planetary system formation says that some of the planets in these systems will be similar to the Earth. And there's now been a multitude of experiments conducted on the chemistry laboratories here on Earth, which show that where you have a planet like the Earth, the chemistry of life develops quite spontaneously and with vigor. It does not require any special circumstances for the first steps in life to develop. We have not traced as yet development of but not the first of those things. But we are close to that. And again, there doesn't seem to be any special circumstances required to rise to the thing. Once you have those relations, they compete for resources, ecological relations, and this is the driver for the for evolution to proceed. And so the picture is one where surely very complicated organisms will develop.